name is Caio Zampieri, and on my today's video we're going to talk about serves.
There are two types of serves, the platform serve and the pinpoint serve. This is the platform serve when you keep your legs apart, lower your legs and jump upwards at the moment of the contact point. This serve is used by Roger Federer and Novak Djokovic, and myself included, after I retired, because I think it's easier to do it. The second is the pinpoint. When you drag and put your legs together, then you bend your legs and jump to catch the ball at the highest contact point. And this type of serve, it's used by Rafa Nadal and Andy Murray. And I used to use this type of serve when I was playing on tour because I think I had more power at the contact point. Start with some explanations. For me, the most important thing in the serve is the continental grip. But to be able to use the continental grip, you need to understand the pronation. The pronation is that movement you do with a racket when you're opening the head of the racket at the moment of the contact point. Sideways position. Stay sideways at the contact point and you rotate your body naturally after hitting the ball. Keep your elbow high when hitting the ball. You should have your arm fully extended, reaching the ball at the highest point you can. The serve is a continuous movement. You must do with rhythm without breaking into parts. It must be a connected movement. So the pronation, if you can realize on this video, how I'm opening the head of my racket at the moment of the contact point. So I start with the continental grip with my racket closed, then I open when I'm gonna hit the ball, and then I close right after the contact point. So here I'm gonna give you some like drills or exercise for the toss and contact point. So this is a simple one: toss the ball with your left hand and catch the ball with your right hand without moving your legs. So contact point drill. Place yourself close to a curtain or a wall. Toss the ball, start with your racket up, and block the ball and hold it up above your head. Place your racket on the floor in front of you. Step on the side of your grip diagonally forward and toss the ball upwards, trying to get the ball to fall in the center of your racket. This drill is very effective. I try with my students, the little ones, the little kids, and it works very well. This exercise is to help you on your kick serve, mostly used as a second serve. Notice how I use my wrist more than my arm right now. That's making the ball spinning forward and dropping fast. Another way to get your toss right is pretend you have a clock over your head, and for the second serve or kick serve, you're gonna toss the ball between 12 and 11. And for the first serve, you need to toss the ball a little bit in front of you, and that's gonna make the toss right at 12 o'clock. In this drill, you're gonna improve your balance and your sideways position. Because if you toss the ball wrong, or you move your body too much, you're gonna fall forward. This is another drill to work on your kick serve. When you place a bench on the baseline, sit on it and do the kick serve, spinning the ball forward and making the ball dropping fast. This is another angle from the same exercise, just to show you guys how I use my wrist very much. Fast serve drill. This exercise will help you to have more acceleration, power and rhythm in your serve. This drill is very similar to the other one, but now you're walking forward to work on your contact points always in front of you and having more power on your serve as well.